On bottom one, Pilots expected to see Cobb, Fajardo, and Robertson coming to the plate. We should be locked in here, full force, the rest of the game. Let's preview this thing properly. We got Pilots taking on Benedictine. LSUS with a 4-0 win just a few moments ago. Benedictine suffered a very difficult walk-off two-run home run. They lost 9-8. Crazy game. They were up 8-0, gave up 9 consecutive runs, including that two-run walk-off to end the game in the loss to Indiana University Southeastern. At the plate now for the Pilots, Cody Cobb. Cobb was the catalyst for LSUS in game one. He was involved on 3 of the 4 runs. He drove in a pair and also scored once, had a stolen base in the game as well. He was the catalyst offensively while Sebastian Selway went 5 innings of shutout baseball, followed by 2 innings of shutout baseball from Trey Rugg. Here's a little soft hit ball to the third baseman. Piontek is going to have a throw that pulls Williams off the bag, and Cody Cobb is going to reach. That will be a hit. That's a tough play for the third baseman. So Cody Cobb with an infield single. Now batting for the Pilots, number 29, Taylor Fajardo. So that'll bring Fajardo to the plate. He'll be followed by Peyton Robertson. This ball is going to be caught by the shortstop, fisted it. Thought he might have gotten just enough of it to bloop it over his head in the no man's land. Coming up is going to be Peyton Robertson now. Now batting for the Pilots, number 1, Peyton Robertson. So Fajardo with a little pop out to the shortstop. Cobb will stay put at first as Peyton Robertson stands in now from the right side. It's going to be a bit low, 1-0. Benedictine 4-1 on the season. Their starting pitcher Rudolph has thrown 1 game. He's 1-0. He went 3 2/3 innings in that game. 2.45 ERA. Struck out 5. Gave up 1 earned run. Count now 1-1. Cobb at first. Always a possibility to run. There he goes. Little hit and run action right there. Cody was bird dogging right there just a little bit. I knew he was on the move. Robertson lifts this one out into right field. No problem for Pavlik. Two away now. As the pilot shortstop. Austin McNicholas coming to the plate. Now batting number three, Austin McNicholas. First pitch, the pilot shortstop. Gonna drop down a bunt, but it'll roll foul. Central Methodist beat USAO 5-4 in a tightly contested game. And of course, the 9-8. Exciting walk-off win for Indiana Southeastern. Heartbreak for Benedictine, of course, after having an 8-0 lead in that game. Good pitch right there. Got him to chase it down. It's 0-2. Rudolph, a junior from Peoria, Illinois, 6'4", 230. Out away. We'll do it all over. Big Nicholas checked on it, held up, 1-2. Benedictine has outscored their opponents 45-19 on the season. Of course, nine of those coming in that last game, so they were at 37-10 through their first four games of the year. Here's the 1-2, the Pilots cleanup hitter. Cobb's on the move again. There he goes. He is going to be out. Yep. So Cobb thrown out, stealing second. McNicholas will lead it off for the Pilots whenever they hit again. We're going top two, scoreless. Thank you. plate, number 25, Jacob Slayton. So Jacob Slayton at the plate here for Benedictine. Count 2-1. This ball is laced out into left field. That'll get down for a base hit. Slayton will pull up at first. He's got a leadoff single here in the second. Now batting number 34, Jordan Williams. That'll bring up Jordan Williams. Williams on the season hitting 250, 2-for-8 with a home run. That one's down low, 1-0. Well, the Pilots got their best pitching performance of the season from Sebastian Selway in game number one here today. Pilots now 3-2 on the year after Selway went 5 shutout innings. Again, this game is scheduled for just 7 innings here. All of the games this weekend will be 7 innings. The game back in Shreveport on Tuesday versus USAO will also be 7 innings. So it kind of helps your pitching out a little bit, knowing you don't have to go the full 9. It makes every pitch count. Here's the 2-0 from the Pilots left-hander Fortenberry. Tell you more about Ford here in just 1 minute. I do apologize. We kind of got off to a slow start here in this broadcast. The sophomore left-hander, 6 foot out of Natchitoches, Louisiana. That pitch flying out to right field. Pinero is there for it. Now batting number 15, Nathan Huber. That'll bring Nathan Huber up to the plate. Huber, a senior, the catcher from Stillwell, Kansas. By the way, that was a 3-run home run that Central Methodist hit. They have a 3-0 lead early in their game. Called strike, looking. A lot of home runs hit so far out here. These are fairly small fields. Obviously, LSUS and Lyon did it without any home runs, but the other two games, there was 8 home runs, I believe, in the Benedictine game, their first game that they played over there. 4 for each side. Runner on the move. Naparowski's throw is going to be a little bit late. Stolen base for Slayton. Fortenberry so far on the season has one of the best ERAs for the Pilots, 1.93 ERA. He's 1-0. He's appeared in 2 games, has 6 strikeouts and 4 2/3 innings of work. He's got a 1-1 count here with a runner on second. Make it 1-2. Two struck him out. Fortenberry sits down another. Yeah. His third strikeout here early in the game. Now batting number two, Jackson Doherty. Bring up Jackson Doherty, the junior from Olathe, Kansas. Called strike. Doherty hitting 273 on the season, 3 for 11. Takes a big hack right there. Comes up with nothing but strike two. Runner is on the move. Struck him out though. Fortenberry with his fourth strikeout here early in the game. Benedictine picks up one hit in the inning, but it's all for naught. Going bottom two, scoreless. Nicholas will stand back in. He was behind in the count 1-2 whenever Cobb was thrown out at second. His first pitch swing in here. Good sliding grab by the shortstop Myers and a beautiful throw over to first base for the first out of the inning. Shortstop to shortstop out right there as McNicholas is retired. Now batting for the Pilots, number 28, Carlos Pinero. A big thank you to the Sterlington Sports Complex for housing us here this weekend. A big thank you to Michael down there. He has three live feeds up right now, and I want you guys to understand how difficult it is to get up three live feeds on basically a day's notice. Tremendous job, Michael. We certainly appreciate you. If at any point you guys lose the feed, maybe you click out of Facebook, you come back, you think you don't see it, just scroll down. You'll see it in the video section. It is there. All the games are up live right now, and a sensational job by him and the Sterlington Sports Complex to house this. This certainly wasn't happening in Shreveport this week, and I think there's still icicles hanging from the dugouts. So it's good that we were able to move this over to Sterlington, and a big thank you to the complex for housing us here. And what a tremendous event this has been already. I mean, goodness gracious, you had a 5-4 game and great pitching late to finish that one off, and then a 2-run walk-off for IU Southeastern over Benedictine. So it's been some fireworks here early on in a tournament that was billed as the Cajun Collision, and it's certainly living up to the hype already. Here's the 2-1 from Rudolph. Got some nice two-seam action right there. That one might have run a little bit too much back to the inside corner. It's 3-1. Thank you. Montanaro chasing that one. Was the count full? Got him. Off speed. Panera was looking for something with a little heat on it. He goes down swinging. Now batting for the Pilots, number 37, Owen Naparowski. So Vasecki got the start in game one. Knapp back behind the plate here for game two. That one's in there for a strike. Knapp, 1-for-4 so far on the season. Make it 2-for-5. It's going to be at least a single. Slayton comes over, cuts it off. Knapp going to try and go 2. He will be in there with a double. He just looked up in the sky like, thank the Lord. And, yeah, Knapp. Hey, look, sometimes it's the risk versus reward of trying to take that base, right? There's also the possibility that guy throws the ball away, just like happened right there. And so Knapp takes second with what will end up being a double. Pitch running will be Chase Spatafora, the Pilot senior. Now batting number 25, Miguel Morgan. So Slayton's throw just a bit off the mark, unable to be corralled there at second base as Naparowski has a two-out double. Really doing a good job changing speeds here. Got the changeup working, a little breaking ball. Pilots have been out in front quite often here early. Then he goes back to the fastball, right by Miguel Morgan upstairs. And that's what a good pitcher does, in and out, changing speeds, in and out, up and down, changing speeds. And right now Rudolph showing you that's his game plan early. Let's see if Morgan can come out with a two-strike, two-out RBI. One's going to be down in the dirt, 1-2. Looking back at last season, I was going to see if Rudolph, he was sensational last year. 2.03 ERA, appeared in 10 games, all in relief, 13 innings of work, only gave up 11 hits, 3 earned runs against him last year. So Isaac Rudolph, very difficult. Opponents hit just 244 against him. Looks like he'll be getting the start here today. Maybe his first start for Benedictine. Let's see if we can look back to 2019 on his stats. Could be his very first start here in collegiate baseball. Yes, all the games he appeared in 2019 were in relief. He strikes out Morgan to end the threat. Isaac Rudolph, Josh Fortenberry exchanging zeros. We're going top three. Thank you. top of the third. Myers set to lead it off here. Leading off, number 36, Daryl Myers. Led off the game with a single to left center. He's going to pop this one up out of play. Peyton Robertson gives chase, but it will head off into the night. It says 57 degrees here in Sterlington. It is not 57 degrees. It's 41. Yeah, no way it's 57. I've never been lied to more in my life than the weather app just lied to me. Here's the 0-1. Off the fist. This one will be playable for Roberts, and he's gotten it for the first out of the inning. Little pop out here in foul territory. Grabbed by Peyton Robertson. Now batting, number 32, Michael Slayton. The game. That one catches the outside corner. Got him looking. Now batting, number 14, Drew Piontek. Piontek at the plate. Good breaking ball to start the at-bat. 0-1. Fouled away. 0-2. Piontek hitting 333 on the season. He's driven in four. Breaking ball. Tried to get that one back to the inside corner. Couldn't get it there. 1-2. Got him. Called strike three. Josh Fortenberry dicing him up out there. He's got six strikeouts through three. Pilots getting the bats back. Hampton set to lead it off for Shreveport. 2-for-3 on the season. Scored a couple of runs. First pitch swinging. Foul back. Rudolph back out to work. He's 26 pitches deep so far. Very efficient and effective first two innings. Oh, by the way, he's thrown 20 strikes and 6 balls. As a former pitcher, you love to see it. Showing bunt, pulling back. Ball number 7. Rudolph has a pair of strikeouts. Fortenberry has 6 so far. Hampton trying to drop one down. And a roll foul. LSUS now 3-2 after their shutout victory over Lyon. Benedictine at 4-1 after the heartbreaking, I mean absolutely heartbreaking. We were watching it. That was a tremendous game over there as this ball is just tapped right back to Rudolph. And he made it a tough play for Williams. Williams got his foot back down. It'll be a ground out. But a heartbreaking loss for Benedictine in that first game. Maldonado with the plate as Rudolph starts him off with a strike on the outside corner. So basically in this game, you have two guys that are relievers getting the starts. Josh Fortenberry did start one game for the Pilots as a freshman. That's going to be a foul ball just to the left side of the bag. It was close. Especially from our angle, it's really tough for us to tell from here, but it was certainly close no matter what. But you have two guys here that are used to being relievers in Rudolph and Fortenberry, and they're exchanging zeros early on. Maldonado fouls that one off, hit that pole. Man, I thought that was something else for a second. Thank goodness it was just the pole. Made a loud thud over there. Always got to have your head on a swivel at the ballpark for sure. Here comes the 0-2 from the big right-hander. Chopped back up the middle. Myers, throw over. Got him for the second out. Now batting, number 7, Cody Cobb. Well, here's the man that has been the spark plug. I don't know what else to say about Cody Cobb at this point, except for I like to watch the kid play baseball. And he delivered earlier as well. He was 8 for 17 coming into the day. Picked up a couple more hits. Actually, he picked up one hit and a couple of walks. More importantly, a couple more RBIs to his credit. Pilots leader in RBIs now with 9 on the season. He's the Pilots' leader in runs scored now with 7 on the season. He's the Pilots' leader in hits with 9. He's the Pilots' offensive leader at this point. I don't care how you break it down right now. This is the guy. Pretty good pitch there. Called a ball, 2-0. Another close one inside, 3-0. Of course, Cobb has already singled in this game, hitting .500 on the season. Ball 4. Ooh, late call right there. That was, I think that surprised everyone, to be honest with you. So 3-1 now the count. It's the umpire. One of the later strike calls that you're going to see. Now Cobb will have to battle as he fouls that one off. Oh, in the dirt. So it'll end up as a walk for Cobb. Now batting number 29, Taylor Fajardo. Well, Cobb has already been thrown out, trying to steal second in this game. I have a feeling you're going to keep him put here and let the power bat of Fajardo swing away, especially with two down. See if he checked. They're going to say that he did. Big time appeal there from the pitcher Rudolph. He wanted it. Slow start to the season for Taylor, but we all know it just takes one swing for things to ignite. He's 1-for-9 on the season. It was a home run. He's driven in 5, though. Look, you've only got one hit, but you've driven in 5. He's done his part. He's got a couple sacrifice flies and has definitely found a way to provide some offense. Another pretty good pitch there from Rudolph. Couldn't get the call on the inside corner. 2-0. Yeah, just a little bit inside there. I have to say the umpire last game was very solid. There wasn't any moments where you're like, oh, that's a horrible call, you know, and we haven't had that necessarily in this game either. So far, the umpiring's been pretty good. That's going to be an error at third base. Third baseman just had it. Should have been an easy play. So error on Piontek will allow Fajardo to reach first as Cobb moves over to second. Now batting number 1, Peyton Robertson. So Rudolph will have to work a little bit harder now. Could have been, probably should have been, out of the inning right there. Now got 2 on and 2 away. He'll have to face the preseason All-American Peyton Robertson. 1-0. Robertson sends one into the game. Heads up play out there and left. Did he catch that? No, he nearly made that play. Big moment in the game here. Again, this game is set for 7 innings, so every pitch is magnifying just a little bit more when you take those final 2 innings off. We play here in the bottom of the 3rd. Rudolph has kept LSUS quiet so far. Robertson trying to make some noise. Cobb saying he balked. Cobb very surprised that wasn't a balk. Tough for me to tell. Robertson drops one in right. It will score 1. They'll be safe at 3rd and 2nd as Peyton Robertson delivers the first run of the game for the Pilots. Peyton doubles to right center. It's 1-0 LSUS. Now batting number 3. Austin McNicholas. Well, Peyton had been getting on base, been hitting the ball well, hadn't really provided that moment yet, right? Hadn't been the timely hitting that you're used to seeing from Peyton Robertson. There it is, the Pilots in a big game here against Benedictine come up with the first run as Peyton Robertson has broken the scoring seal on this one. The threat looms, though, now with 2 on. 2 in scoring position, I should say, and McNicholas at the plate. And this is outside 1-0. comes the 1-0 to the Pilot shortstop. Austin swung through it, 1-1. Well, once again, it's Cody Kopp coming around to score, setting the table for this offense. McNicholas hits one deep to right, on the way to make a tremendous grab as Pavlik might have just saved the day for Benedictine. Would have made it 3-0 and would have kept the inning running. McNicholas just can't get those breaks at the moment. And he flies out to right to the end of the inning, but LSUS pushes one across. Pilots have a 1-0 lead. We're going top four. So Jacob Pavlik at the dish. He's behind 0-1. Fortenberry has been just sensational through the first three. He struck out six already. One strike away now from matching the seven that was thrown up by Sebastian Selway in the Pilots shutout in game one. Struck him out. That's seven strikeouts in the game. Fortenberry is eating them alive right now. Now batting number five, Danny Favazza. You don't want to get too far ahead of yourself, but this is literally a 180 from what you saw in the opening weekend from the Pilots pitching staff. They go give up, 42 runs in the first four games, and you've just gone 10-plus innings here of shutout baseball. This is what this team needed to reinvigorate the pitching staff, put some confidence in that pitching staff, and show that it can be done. And look, what does it come down to? What did you see week one? Too many balls, too many walks. Right now the Pilots are filling up the strike zone, and it's paying off. There's a ball. Count 1-1. Fortenberry, 48 pitches, 33 for strikes, 15 balls. I mean, right where you want to be, really. This one's going to be back up the middle. Nearly sliced away. He'll be safe. That will be a hit. That's a tough play. That really difficult to judge right there from my angle. I thought it was going to be a base hit up the middle, and it sliced hard back on Maldonado, and he did a good job to make the grab, but ultimately it'll be a little infield single for Favazza. At the plate, number 25, Jacob Slayton. So Slayton singled to left and stole a base. He'll be back in for this righty versus lefty matchup. back. Four hits for Benedictine, three for LSUS. Picking up again here, blowing from left to right, not necessarily blowing out at all, but more so kind of cutting off anything that would be hit deep. The other fields would be much more impacted by the wind, the way it's blowing at the moment. Fort Berry checking over on Favaza at first. Favaza 1-for-2 so far this year in stolen base attempts. Benedictine has run quite a bit here early. They're 12-for-17. The Pilots nearly identical there. They're 13-of-16. Of course, LSUS has been thrown out once in this game. Cobb was thrown out back in the first, trying to steal second. Breaking ball slips out of the back of the hand there, 2-1. Fort and Berry with a couple neck rolls. You know, one thing that is something to pay attention to in this game is how many pitches does Fort and Berry have. He's not generally a starter. You know, you have to pay attention to those things, but no doubt the confidence is brimming right now, and he's been electric so far in this one. Misses outside. 3-1 now. Is it 6-1? Central Methodist up on Indiana Southeastern. Runner will steal second. Maldonado tried not to land on Favaza, but Favaza has just stolen another base here. His second, or the second, I should say, for Benedictine in this game. Full count. Three balls, two strikes, one out. Runner in scoring position after that stolen base. Struck him out, Fortenberry, with his eighth strike out of the game. And that's a big one right there. As he gets Slayton for the second out of the inning. Now batting number 34, Jordan Williams. That'll bring up Williams. He flied out to right field in his first plate appearance. He'll bat with a runner in scoring position here and two away. That ball is laced to right again, but it will be caught out there by Pinero. So a well-hit ball off the bat of Jacob Williams, but that's going to do it. Josh Fortenberry scoreless through four. Pilots lead 1-0, bottom four. Panero back in for his second time in the game. Went down swinging in his first plate appearance against Rudolph. Starts him off for the strike. Rudolph, again, that two-seam action, really running the ball back in on the right-handers. We've seen it continuously here. And he's living with that off-speed. 0-2. Panero fights that one off. Carlos on the season came into today hitting 600. He was 6-for-10. I believe he had a hit in game one as well. I'm trying to think back real quick. Dak Stats has not updated the stats from game one just yet. Two pitches now for Isaac Rudolph. Here comes number 53. Outside, 1-2. Rudolph has been very efficient himself. 37 of those 53 have been in the zone. That one misses, 2-2. Laced right back up the middle. Perfectly played. Good scoop by Williams at first as well. But they had Slayton in the perfect position right there. Kind of tip your cap right there on the positioning. Now batting number 37, Owen Naparowski. Yeah, and obviously you risk right there leaving the right side open, but sometimes, and we've seen it so much in the major leagues, obviously at this level, you don't really have the data to say, hey, this guy's a dead pull hitter. We know we're gonna play him this way. Look at this ball just dropped and rolling down the first baseline. Naparowski is going to shut it down this time. He was nearly thrown out going for second last time. This time he thought better of it. He'll shut it down at first, but back-to-back hits now for Owen Naparowski. That's right. Went against the shift, and he was thinking the other way the whole time right there. He ends up hitting it down the right, you know, the first baseline, but thinking the other way is always a good approach at the plate right there. It nets Naparowski his second hit of the game. Spanafora will pinch run again at the plate. Number 25, Miguel Morgan. So one on, one out now in a 1-0 game. As Miguel Morgan stands in from the right side. First pitch swinging. Sends this one into the opposite field's bullpen. Spanafora at first has run a few times this year. He's 2-for-3 in stolen base attempts. Pilots have been aggressive. Here comes the 0-1. Probably a pretty good time to check over there on Spat. Again, this is a 7-inning game. All games this weekend will be 7 innings. So this ball is dropped out into left center field. Good job by the left fielder to get over there and cut that one off quickly. But both guys are going to move up. It's a double from Miguel Morgan. The Pilots was something cooking here. At the plate, number 8, Mike Hampton. So Miguel Morgan does his part, puts a couple. Miguel Morgan. Oh, the last game? In the 8-hole. Yeah. Mike started this game here. The last game in the 8-hole for the Pilots was... Okay, gotcha. Yeah, Mike is making the start here for LSUS out in right field. Hey, Hampton's been good so far this year as well. 2 for 3. Actually, he's now 2 for 4 after grounding out in this game, but he was 2 for 3 in his limited action. Got an opportunity here to drive a couple in. Pilots have 2 outs to work with. Maldonado waiting on deck. Down in the dirt, 1-0. They're going to intentionally walk Hampton. That'll set up the force at any base. Now batting, number 2, Zeke Maldonado. So Maldonado is going to hit with them juiced here. Obviously, there's some risk in intentionally walking Hampton. There is also some reward if you can get a ground ball here and throw the man out at home. So, big moment in the game. We're at the halfway point of this game, essentially. Here's the dangerous part. You have Cody Cobb waiting on deck. So you have now put it in a situation where Cobb's probably going to see an at-bat here, barring a double play. That's a strike. Chasing it down low, 0-2. That looked like one of those trying to be the hero type swings right there. See if he can refocus the mindset here behind the count now, 0-2. Here is the 0-2. Down in the dirt. Top of lay off that one, 1-2. Maldonado was sensational here last year against LSUS in the LSUS versus Cumberland 4-game series at Sterlington. Here's the 1-2. Maldonado hits it to short. Bobbled by Myers, he'll make the throw to first. It will lead to a run. So Maldonado does his part. It's now 2-0 LSUS, and Cody Cobb has a chance to hit with 2 outs and 2 on. So Naparowski scores. Morgan goes to third. Hampton moves down to second. And that's going to bring up Cody Cobb. Looks like head coach Eric Peterson may be going to the pen. At the very least, wants to have a conversation here with Isaac Rudolph. Bringing in the whole infield here, so I'm guessing Rudolph's going to stay in the game. Big moment, though. So here's the next thought that you have to have if you're Eric Peterson. I don't know if he understands how absolutely hot Cody Cobb has been. This is probably the spot where I would walk this guy, but waiting on deck may be the guy with the most power in the entire ballpark, Taylor Fajardo. So it's a tight spot right here, no matter what, for BC. At the plate right now, number 7, Cody Cobb. Well, he has been the one that has delivered at bat after at bat so far this year. Let's see if he can do it again. Takes it inside, 1-0. He's 1 for 1 in this game. He's walked and scored a run. He's also been thrown out stealing. But right now, it's all about this at-bat and seeing if he can add to this 2-0 lead. Called strike on the outside corner, 1-1. Cobb hits it down the third baseline. It'll score one. Cody Cobb delivers once again. I'm ruling that a hit. That ball is down the line. It's hit hard. Cody Cobb with a base hit. So Morgan comes in to score. Hampton moves down to third. As Cobb delivers once again. At the plate, number 29, Taylor Fajardo. It's 3-0 LSUS. That ball way outside from Rudolph. And again, I'm going to mention it every time Fajardo comes up. I know he's a little bit cold right now. There's a lot of power in that bat. And this field in particular, at 3:15 down the line, I'm just saying. Now it's going to be on the outside corner, 1-1. Fajardo smashes one to left. It'll keep it rolling. Taylor delivers. It's 4-0 LSUS. So Hampton scores. Cobb moves all the way to third base on the base hit from Taylor Fajardo. Now batting, number one, Peyton Robertson. Here comes P-Rob. He had a timely hit to drive across the Pilots' first run of the game as he scored Cobb. See if he can do it again here with two outs. Outside corner, got him looking, 0-1. Inside, evens things up. That ball is up around the letters, 2-1. Peyton came into today hitting 353. Sliced. Foul. 1-2. 2-2, excuse me. Robertson chops it out to Slayton, who cannot come up with that one. It's 5-0 LSUS. That was a tough play for Slayton to try and come back to. As Robertson rolls that one slowly on the infield. Cobb comes around to score again. At the plate, number three, Austin McNicholas. The Pilots have busted things open here in the fourth inning. 5-0 LSUS. Quick check of the scores over there. 6-2. Central Methodist still ahead of Indiana Southeastern. And 3-0. I think USAO's up over there, correct? Yeah, USAO with a 3-0 lead over Lyon. Good pitch right there. Has McNicholas out in front, 0-1. Well, this has turned into a big inning. Pilots with a couple stolen bases. So he turns them loose. Fajardo and Robertson move up into scoring position. They'll both add some stolen bases to their tally. That's 5 on the season now. 5 for 5 for Peyton Robertson. Count 1-1. McNicholas. I'm not sure if he went. They're going to say that he did go. 1-2. Just feel like Austin can't really catch a break right now. It's just, you know, kind of in that moment. Well, this has by far been the longest inning we've seen here today. McNicholas back up the middle. Myers with a great play, and he'll throw out McNicholas again. Austin hits it hard again, though. That's a well-struck ball. Just hit it right at somebody, and he just can't buy one at the moment. But LSUS buys 4 in the inning. It's 5-0 Pilots. We're going top 5.